Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome folks, we will start this video with the new topic, and it's all about Kotlin collections. Well, if you are coming from any programming language for that matter, collections are not really new. In Kotlin also, it is pretty much the same thing. So what you have is basically collection interface, and there are basically two types of collections. One is list and another one is set. And collection itself is basically an interface which inherits from the iterable. And iterable in turn has a concrete implementation called as mutable iterable. And then we have mutable collection, which basically is a sub interface that inherits from the mutable iterable and collection. And then we have sub interfaces of the list and set called as mutable list and mutable set. And both of these are an extension of mutable collection. And you might be wondering, in this set of Kotlin collections that we have seen so far, where is the map? Well, map doesn't really come under direct hierarchy of collections. It is a separate thing. But once again, it also has a mutable map. This can be really overwhelming for someone who is looking at it for the first time and might really get confused as to where to use what and in which manner. So I will try to simplify it. So let's start with something simple, that is list. List is nothing but an array of homogeneous elements which are basically indexed in the insertion order. That is how you add, they are just appended one after another, and you can add a duplicate element in a list. However, in case of a set, it is non-indexed and there is no particular order. As you add elements, it just keeps on adding those elements into a set. One extra advantage of a set over a list is it ensures that there are no duplicate entries in the set. And set has a lot of operations which are similar to mathematical set operations like union, mutual exclusion that you typically hear in mathematics. And then of course you have a map, which are completely different things, which are key value pairs, also referred to as dictionary. With this basic understanding of what Kotlin collections look like, let's actually get into a demo. And in this video, we'll only look at how do we construct these collections. So in this video, let's start with, say, construction of list. So what I can do is I can create var names, and I can create a list of names. So names would be of string type. So what I can write is, say, Anil. So these are the names, and if I can just print here, it is just going to print me the names. That's all. And as you can see here, that's the list of the names. However, what you can also do is, instead of constructing list of names like this, you can write something like build list of type string and put these things inside this flower bracket. But there is a particular way you need to do this. What I will do is add Anil and then write multiple names here. And as you can see here, we are seeing a compilation error. It is a complaining that I need to add a option experimental standard library. So let's just add that. And now if I run this, it just gives me pretty much the same way of list. In both the cases, that is whether you use the build list or list of, this names is immutable. What do I mean by that is you cannot add more names once you create the list. That is, if I write something like names.add, I can't do anything. And even also names.remove, there is nothing called as remove option here because this is immutable. However, if you want to do that, you can do something like mutable list. Now, how do I do that? So let me just recreate this mutable list of string, and then this is our initial names. And what I can now do is names.add. And now you can see that I can add a element here. And if I run this, now you will see that a new element has been added, and it is added at the end. And if I add another element here, they are all just added one after another. And that's the specialty of list. And you can even add at a particular index. So if I want this to be added at second, I can do that. So in that case, this will not be added at the end. It will be added at a particular index. So the whole idea is index is being maintained with the list. And by default, whenever you add an element to the list, it is always added at the end. So this is about list. But what if I have a set? And once again, similar to the list of, you can write set of, and just like you have a mutable list of, you can write mutable set of, and in the same way you can write build set, just like you had a build list. And when you use set of and build set, both of them are immutable. But however, instead of that, if I write mutable set of string, then you can see that I cannot add with the index, because in case of set, no index is maintained. However, I can add this, and if I just run it, it just works perfectly fine. And another thing is, if I try to add one more thing, it will not complain. However, if I run and see the contents, you will see that Mithila has been added only once. You can't add it more than once because the duplication is not allowed. However, instead of mutable set of, if I had a list of strings and if I had done a duplicate entry, it would have allowed to go on. That is the major difference between the list and a set. The last one more thing that I want to now look into is basically maps. It is pretty similar. So let me create var city states map, and what I can write is map of two things, that is string and string. And how do I initialize? I will write, say, Bengaluru to Karnataka. That's the map, that is Bengaluru is a capital of Karnataka state. And I can do this by just adding multiple entries. And if I just print city states map, it is going to give me a key value pair of Bengaluru associated with Karnataka, Chennai associated with Tamil Nadu, and Panjim associated with, of course, sorry about that, it's Goa. And since it is map of, I can't add another item in this. So for example, city states map dot, I can't put or add. That is not available. Even if I had used something like build map, that also would not have been possible. If I write like this, let me comment it out. And how do I add elements using build map? You write put key value, and instead of 2, you use comma. And let me complete this. This is also immutable. If I try to add city dot add or put, there is no such functionality. However, instead of this, I had mutable map of strings, and then I can add another key value pair here, that is city map put, say Mumbai, Maharashtra. And if I run this, you will see that another item has been added into the city states map. So in this video, we have only seen how to construct these collections, that is list, sets, and maps. In the next video, we will look at how to work with these things in a much more useful way. So stay tuned for that particular video. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.